Hi YouTube, this is Robert with Soy. Welcome to Getting Wwiser episode 1.5, or 2.5. Well, either way, with the coming of UE 4.7, the past tutorials I made about building engines are more or less useless. So if you haven't guessed already, this episode we will build a new 4.7 engine and integrate it with Wwiser. That being said, this tutorial will go faster than the first two tutorials. And with that, let's get started. So as before, we need to download our repositories from github.com, both the UE4 engine and the Wwiser integration. Once you have downloaded it, extract the 4.7 files into the folder where you want your engine to be. This time we don't have to unzip the dependencies, Unreal was nice enough to include that for us. As you can see in the demo, I'm once again putting the file on my D drive. You can place this file anywhere you want on your computer. This takes a bit, so I'll just skip ahead. Once it is extracted, open up the folder and find the file called setup. Double-click it. This essentially takes the place of unzipping all the dependencies into our engine. What it is doing is updating your engine with all the things we need, like HTML5 or things like that. This process will take a while. And with that, once again in the demo, I will skip ahead. Once it is done, we need to double-click generateprojectfiles.bat. This will create a new Visual Studio Solutions file that we will use to build our engines. Once the Visual Studio's file is done, open it. When it opens, it'll ask you if we trust everything. Remember, we do, so all we have to do is unclick the box and click OK. Now when looking at Visual Studio, find the folder called UE4. Mine is on the top left. Yours might be on the top right. Now all we have to do is right-click it and click Build. I'll skip ahead once again. This process takes about 30 minutes or more. After it has been built, we can extract our Wwiser files into the UE4 folder. Remember to click Yes to All. If you do not get this prompt, that means you did not extract the files into the right folder. Once again, this process will take some time. I'll just skip ahead. Once it is done, we now have to grab four folders from Wwiser and place them into our engine. So to navigate to them, we go to C, Program Files 86, Audio Kinetic, the Wwiser version, and then SDK. Three of the folders we need are called Include, Windows 32 VC120, and X64 VC120. We will place them into our Engine, Source, Third Party, and then Audio Kinetic. Copy and paste those three folders now. Once this is done, we will create a new folder and name it Samples. Go back to our Wwiser folder and open up their Samples folder. In there, you will find something called Sound Engine. Copy and paste Sound Engine from their folder into our folder. Once that is done, let's go back to our main engine folder. From here, you will now have to click on the Visual Studio Solution file that we made earlier. When it is open, once again, find the file called UE4. Right-click it and click Rebuild, not Build. This will integrate all of Wwiser into your engine. Once again, this will take about 30 minutes or more, so I'll just skip ahead. Once that is done, close out Visual Studios and then click on GenerateProjectFiles.bat one more time. After that is done, click on the new Visual Studio Solutions file. And this time when it opens, click Build, not Rebuild, on UE4. This just makes sure that your engine is up to date. This step does not take nearly as long, only a few minutes. Once it is done, now we can go to our Wwiser demo game. Let's navigate to it and open it up. Sometimes it'll ask you to choose an engine when you first start it up. All you have to do is click the dots and find the path to your engine. Once it is open, we can now set our Wwiser project and our Wwiser version path. Last time, I showed you a very lengthy video on how to set it up by going into several obscure places to set our project and engine path. Well, Audio Kinetic was kind enough to put it in for us. Now all we have to do is just go to Edit, Project Settings, and then scroll down till you find Wwiser. Now all you have to do is click the dots on the side and find where your Wwiser project path is. It is a lot simpler now. And the same goes for choosing your Wwiser version. All you have to do is click C, Program Files 86, Audio Kinetic, and then choose the version folder that you want. And that concludes this session of Getting Wwiser. Next time I'll show you how to attach sounds to objects so you can hear them as if they're coming from a car or a person or something like that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time!